This state-of-the-art robot is making it easier to create hundreds of advanced materials aimed at improving human health called polymers.
Polymer is basically the base component of a plastic. And so you can have very simple kind of commodity-based plastics and polymers, like such as plastic bags. But then also we use polymers a lot for very high-end applications, such as electronics, drug delivery, cancer therapies, and coatings for like airplanes.
Adam Gormley is an assistant professor of biomedical engineering at Rutgers University. Gormley and Tomasi teamed up to develop an automated system where researchers could rapidly create and test a wide variety of polymers.
Generally, actually, in order to make polymers, you need to do it under very inert conditions, under fume hoods and things like that. So we figured out back in 2014 how to do these under kind of open air conditions.
The discovery led them to developing this liquid handling robot that is programmed to synthesize polymers, including fibers for chemical and biological applications.
So if you have, for example, arthritis in the knee and you want to re-engineer that tissue as a replacement, we generally make those out of polymers. And so the polymers that we make with our robotics are very similar to the polymers that you would implant into the body.
Prior to the development of a robot, a chemist could spend hours to even days making a single polymer. And now it'll take a fraction of the time.
So we did a head-to-head comparison of the robotics versus a student. And the student took about 96 different polymers. And the student took a little over 3 hours to make these materials, whereas our robotics did it in under 30 minutes. Even before the robotics, you still needed to be a polymer chemist. You still needed to know how to make polymers. And so what we did was design really nice software that allowed the non-expert, non-polymer chemists to be able to design these materials, and then the robotics would handle all of the necessary math to effectively design these materials and synthesize them with very little effort.
Tomasi says the final product is a game changer when it comes to developments in medicine.
So one example or one way that you could potentially deliver insulin is to swallow like a little tablet instead of an injection. And it's coated in a polymer, and then that polymer, when it hits your large intestine, basically breaks apart and delivers the insulin, and your body can absorb it.
Gormley says because the demand for polymers outpaces their supply, they are now working to commercialize the technology as a Rutgers startup. In Piscataway, Raven Santana, NJTV News.